Good morning, Nick Hayton here on my morning walk. As you can see from these leads, I've got my dogs with me today, and let's hope they behave themselves. In the last couple of conversations, we've been talking about finding investment, finding funding, how to approach investors, and we're now touching on regional differences, cultural differences, the specifics, the little things that matter, that shows the recipient of your pitch, your sales proposition, your project, that you are sensitive to their needs and the needs of the region. And as you'll know by now, we spend a lot of time advising founders and entrepreneurs, taking their projects to our community of investors in the Middle East. And, you know, that is a significantly wide community. And but it's also very, very difficult to navigate the Middle East communities. You have the families, you have that sort of blurred line between sovereign money, private money, and, you know, country money in a sense. And the gap between public and private partnership is very slim. But in a sense, that's why it works and has been hugely successful. So if you go to an average family, they're very difficult to pin down. They just won't talk to you unless you've got some history with them. They won't talk to you unless they've met you. And it takes 6, 7, 8 meetings or more to get to know them, so they trust you. And it takes a while. And if you start selling to them too early, they just back away. You've got to get to know them as people. You've got to understand the family and where they play and what they're looking for. Equally, a sovereign fund, you know, they deploy enormous amounts of capital. Some of these funds run into hundreds of billions now. But within a fund, there is often 100, 200 different allocators of capital. There's a lot of specialisms that go on. There's a lot of people that focus on distinct areas. And, you know, you go in blindly to one of the big sovereign funds, unless you hit it, you know, 1 in 100, 1 in 200. Unless you hit it completely right, the chances are you're going to be talking to somebody who works in a different area. And, you know, if you sent them a long pitch deck, which they're not going to read, it's going to fall on deaf ears, and you're wasting your time. And the other thing, of course, is yes, there's traditional VCs and private equity firms and other investors in the region, and you know, they're all pretty good. But what I would say is a lot of people go to the Middle East because of the families. They go there because of the sovereign funds. They go there because the region loves tech. They love innovation. They like getting in early. They like investing in things that they're going to use, which we can touch on. So it's a great region. It's my favorite region. It should be your favorite region too, but it comes with a degree of strategic thinking on how to approach it, which we'll go into in the next few conversations. Talk soon. Bye for now.